For so long I carried the weight of my past, crippled by burdens like stones on my back. I thought I had fallen too far from your grace.
Welcome to Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you today.
When I was lost, so searching, you were the ground beneath my feet. When I was a blind man begging, you were the eye so I could see.
Hey, welcome to Worldwide Recovery Radio. We're sorry, we apologize for a little bit of a delay this morning. I know
technical issues.
Yes, yeah. You know what? A glitch here and there, but the devil's not going to slow us down.
That's right.
Anyways, I'm Mike, your host today. I'm with my co-host John over there in the corner.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. I greeted you a lot softer
yes.
this time.
Yes, so, you did.
So I had more practice.
That's what the Lord wanted.
Your feelings. So yes, I got chastised. Yes.
Reset.
So and then the lovely Val who. Keeps us all in line. So good morning.
Good morning. Good to be
good
here.
Yeah, we're gonna call her troublemaker.
Yeah,
we've been trouble all morning.
I love
all
that.
All right. You're like fired up today.
Yeah. I am.
You really are. It's like wow. Okay, she has had an extra shot.
A lot of coffee.
This morning.
Yeah, I'm drinking a lot of water.
Yeah,
that's good. Uh-huh. You're hydrated.
Yeah, caffeine.
That's right.
Well,
caffeine,
hydrated water.
This is the undehydrated Valerie
there
version.
There you go.
So, anyways, Recovery Radio. We're glad you're listening this morning, wherever you are. All over the world, we're live streaming, so you get to see our beautiful faces. Also, if if you can go to Facebook or Recovery Radio LHC, and you'll be able to plug it right in and watch the show today. John, will you open us up in prayer? Please?
I would love to. I'd love to. Heavenly Father, hey, just thank you so much, Lord, for all you do for us, and I'm just grateful and just worship you for letting us have this time together. That we could actually come and point people towards you and to celebrate what you've done for us in our lives. Yes. Lord, I pray that you just use this time now that we could be your mouthpiece and reach those people that are hurting and need some guidance to come to you and learn the truth. You know, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, the air team members were so grateful, thankful. I mean, that's what keeps this station on the air. So we're very thankful there. And we have our own sponsors, which is nice, sponsor people who sponsor this program right. specifically. So we're really grateful for them. Fel, you want to tell our listeners who they are?
I'd be honored. Ohana Poke Bowl, bringing authentic Hawaiian Poke Bowl and Hawaiian foods to you. They're located at 3269 Maricopa Avenue. Website is ohanapokelhc.com. Phone number is 928-733-5104. Another local one is Ace Pest Control, 20 years serving LHC, termites, pests, and weeds. Phone number is 928-680-0988. Website is acepestcontrolaz.com. We also have Sunshine RV. Experience sales and service at its best with Kyle and the gang. At Sunshine RV, their address is 2995 Maricopa Avenue. Phone number is 928-855-6648. They also now have a new north side location on Highway 95 near Dillard's at the shops. And then also we'd like to thank Hilltop Community Church. They provide the hats and shirts for us. Their address is 3180 McCulloch Boulevard North. Website is hilltoplhc.com. We'd also like to thank that anonymous sponsor. You know who you are, and we thank you.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Isn't that great?
That is great.
Quite a few sponsors.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
We've got another special one coming up maybe next week. Next week or two to announce. Yeah. So we thank you, sponsors, so much because it provides lots of needs for specifically for the radio program.
Yeah.
And we're thankful for you. Mm-hmm. Let me just briefly explain what this program is all about. We're here to help you. We're here to share our hope, our experience, our past, all of our stuff that we've struggled with and continue to struggle with. I mean, just because we have some time under our belt doesn't mean that we don't fall short. We do that every day.
Yeah,
let's face
sure.
it. All of us do. Mm-hmm. So hopefully we can inspire you. Today or past shows, you're able to go and listen and then watch past shows. So hopefully we've given you some inspiration. We've had about 60 guests on the show. Wow. We've got Dr. Rosen coming up in 2 weeks, I believe.
I'm excited for that
one. Yeah, yeah, me too. It's gonna be good. To really go over the pandemic and, and talk about some of the challenges within the medical field in a hospital and everything else. So really looking forward to that, kind of get some straight answers.
Yeah. Yeah.
And, and hopefully we'll be able to help you through that. John, you want to tell them what we're not about?
Sure, sure. What we are not is we are not here to fix anybody. We do not have that kind of power. Only Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, does. He's the only one that can fix you. What we are here for is to come together and just like the Bible says, to lift each other up, pray for each other. The experiences we go through in life, like Mike said, those are given to us for a reason. There's nothing new under the sun. Yeah. Everything keeps repeating itself. There's nothing, you know, you think you've got something and you're the only person that's suffering with whatever it is you're going through. Any hurt, you know, or some kind of habit or some kind of addiction you're under. You think I'm the only one. The devil wants to isolate you. And that's what he's doing. Mm-hmm. He's pulling you back and saying, yeah, you're the only person that suffers doing this. You know, and that's what he's trying to do. So we're here to come together to lift each other up and let you know you're not alone.
Yes.
You know, two strands are not easily broken.
That's
three
right.
is even more difficult.
That's right.
You know, and that's what we're here for.
Right.
Yeah. Amen.
Especially when you have three stubborn strands.
Yeah.
Like three in this studio.
Huh?
Yeah.
See what I did there?
It's a good thing I'm not the only stubborn one. Sorry, Bill.
Yeah. I didn't say anything. What are you talking about me for?
I said three, Bill.
We just assumed it was three guys.
Yeah.
It was a three
also,
in the studio.
Also in the studio. Also in the studio.
Are you saying there's four?
Is our engineer Bill, who we couldn't
Poor
do
Bill.
This program without. He has to put up with us the whole time.
Yeah.
So
every Saturday.
He enjoys every
rough.
Minute.
Yeah. His poor Saturdays, he could be sitting home doing something more productive, and he's here.
Yeah, amen. Yeah, we're
thankful.
Oh,
yeah, bringing hope and healing to people. That's pretty productive, I'd say.
Taking a nap.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, you know, there's lots of ways to get a hold of us. One is RecoveryRadioLHC.com. And you could go right to our website. You can watch the program live. You can watch past programs, as I said. But not only that, there is so much information about everything that we talk about today. Mm-hmm. We back up with information for you to go look up, whether it be a meeting for Narcotics Anonymous, AA, CR, which is Celebrate Recovery. Suicide hotlines,
grief share.
Yeah, there's so many. We've done so many hours of input work to put in the computer so that you have access to all of that. Everything that we have, you can look up, and that's really important.
It really is.
All useful tools.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Really
Very
important.
Yeah.
Val, what's our scripture today?
Scripture today is James 2:18. Now someone may argue, some people have faith, others have good deeds. But I say, how can you show me your faith if you don't have good deeds? I will show you my faith by my good deeds.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Good deeds, doing good.
Fruit of the Spirit.
That's right?
That's
yeah.
how you see
yeah,
it.
It shows. It shows what we're doing as Christians. Mm-hmm. People should be able to see.
Yeah.
You know, that we're a changed person or that we're willing to just go help.
Right.
Go and do.
That's it.
I think it's important with this scripture, too, is remember we can't out-hustle. We can't do the works to show that. It comes as fruit. When you're following God, you'll see that joy. You'll see that generosity. You'll see that patience. You'll see all of those things.
And that's kind of where religion goes. If you look at religion, religion is man-made. And religion is how we work our way to heaven, where Christianity and following Christ is completely flipped the other way. Christ did all the work for us to get into heaven. So you accept him and you follow him. And then, like you said, you have the fruits from that. And that's where that comes from. You know, it's one thing to say you believe and go on your life doing whatever you want to do. You have no fruit. You've got nothing. So are you really a believer? Are you really a follower?
Right.
You know, and that's one of the things I dealt with in my younger years when I accepted Christ. I accepted Christ out of the fear. You know, I don't want to go to that place. I don't want to go to hell, you know, and it was big fear tactics back in the 70s. You know, the whole left behind movement. Mm-hmm. You're going to be left behind. That scares you. My parents are going to be gone. I'm going to be left here by myself. No way. You know, so it was that big fear factor. So you accept Christ, but then nobody followed through with, what does that mean? I believe he's the Son of God. You know, I believe he was born of a virgin. I believe he lived a sinless life. Mm-hmm. I believe that he died on the cross to pay for the price for my sins. And I believe he ascended into heaven, you know, after he rose from the dead. So I forgot that part. Yeah, so he rose from the dead and then he ascended into heaven. You know, so I believe all that. And I believe everything in that, you know, what I read in the Bible. But nobody told you how to live. So you just think, okay, accept Christ. I got the golden ticket. I'm going to heaven. And you go about your life as normal. So, and a lot of people, what do you do? What do you do? What do you do after you've said the prayer, you know, quote unquote, the prayer?
Are you under discipleship?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's it. And that's where we need a lot more discipleship out there, yeah. I think.
Well, this is a live call-in show. Mm-hmm. Our number, 800-721-9313, and the mm-hmm. local number, 928-855-9110. When you call in, you enter into the drawing to win a shirt or a hat, which are mm-hmm. nice prizes that we give away, which is donated by Hilltop, and we appreciate that.
Yeah, if you look at the live stream, for you'll sure. see the shirts.
Yes, you will.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mike's modeling it right now.
Yes, he is.
He makes a wonderful model.
Oh, thank you. Yes. Yes. So I told you she was troubled
renowned.
Today.
Yes.
She's fired up today.
Yeah.
Wait, I do want to clarify something I said just a minute ago about fruits of the Spirit. Mm-hmm. I did say generosity. I don't want people to misinterpret that. Mm. That was not a fruit of the Spirit. That's just something I was talking about. I see in Christians. Yes. I see in people who are believers.
To be naturally mm-hmm. generous.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, I mean, that's... Mm-hmm.
That flows from the love.
Yes.
It is.
The love others.
That's Christianity.
The goodness,
yes,
all
kindness,
of that.
That's right.
It does.
So really important. Anyways, our topic today, obviously, is, as I said in the beginning, actions, taking the actions mm-hmm. and what it does if you're taking worldly actions, mm-hmm. If you're taking Christian actions. Mm-hmm. They're two different things with most of the time two different endings, whether it be consequences or blessings.
Yeah. So, and that's just it. You know, a lot of people will point their finger at God and be all mad. And why did you allow this to happen? It's like it was your actions that brought you to that, and what you did in your life. Sometimes, you know, the decisions you make today can have lasting consequences in the future.
Yeah, you know, there are a lot of people that don't believe in God, but mm-hmm. but it's amazing how he's the first one that they blame.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Knowing that he does exist, but they don't have anything to do with him. But when anything goes bad, they blame
mm-hmm.
God.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, exactly.
When it's not God, it's you and your choices and your actions, mm-hmm. and you're following Satan, because that's what Satan's all about, the distraction, the destruction,
mm-hmm.
The lies, the ruining of marriages and mm-hmm. homes and mm-hmm. children, and mm-hmm. and there's consequences there when you do that, you know, taking those actions. So.
Exactly.
I'll speak for myself. When I've made poor choices, usually it's not an action I'm taking. For me personally, it's a reaction to something that I've not worked on. I've not been intentional about mm-hmm. seeking God in that and drawing closer to him and reading the word and understanding those things about myself, because some of the traumas that I experienced as a young child, mm-hmm. I do have to work on that daily because it's some of my fear-based reactions mm-hmm. instead of a patient action of what the Holy Spirit is prompting me to do. There's a big difference in
there
too.
There is, and a lot of times, how many people, you the listener, how many times, and I do it myself at the same time, just rush in to either fix something or mm-hmm. someone or take care of a situation, and then it causes that situation to actually get worse.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly.
I mean, been there, done that a million times.
Exactly.
And I too have to, you know, fight that that humanness to go and help, to go and do, mm-hmm. and rather than get out of God's way.
Yeah.
How many times do we get in God's way within the challenges of life?
And, we all have those knee-jerk reactions, you know, based on something that's happened in our past or something we've learned through time, and something happens. Usually it's a stressful situation. Something pops up that causes you stress or something, mm-hmm. and you want to alleviate that right away. So you have a knee-jerk reaction to take care of it. Yeah. And you're right, and you're totally getting in the way of what God has planned for that. But in the same sense, that knee-jerk reaction, God knows you're going to do that.
Ooh,
and he's putting you into that situation to teach you something. Exactly.
John's up here preaching today.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah. So we'd love to hear from you and some of your actions that have either blessed your family or caused you some situations and what took place in your life. We'd love to hear the victories, but at the same time, we love to hear reality.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, the truth that making poor mm-hmm. decisions and taking that action can really cause harm to other people and families and stuff like that. So 1-800-721-9313.
Yeah.
A couple of shout outs that I want to do. Okay. I want to do a shout out to Barbara to get well.
Yeah.
Barbara, we're praying for you. Mm-hmm. Hope that you that you recover and you're on the mend. And mm-hmm. My friend Sherry, we take actions and we do things and we're praying for her. She's got a busted up leg and she's in a wheelchair and in this wild kind of cast and lots of challenges and struggles. And she's within the caretaking world can no longer do that right now.
That's rough.
She's in a challenging spot. And again, you know, the actions we take are critical. Everything and every move that we make, we have to think of doing the right thing. Is this what God wants me mm-hmm. to do, right?
Yeah.
So we're praying for you, Sherry, for a full healing.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
We know that God's got a purpose for you in your life and a direction, and we have to take the action to trust that.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Right?
Amen.
Not trying
exactly
to fix the whirlwind situation where if I do this, if I do that. Just get out of the way.
Yeah.
Work on your healing and your relationship. Sometimes sometimes God, he put me in jail to get my attention.
In
the quiet time, he did the same thing. I'm going to bring in Paul. He did the same thing with Paul.
Mm-hmm.
Everywhere Paul went, they threw him in prison.
Yeah.
Well, he did his best writing and his best work in prison. There's a purpose for things,
right?
Mm-hmm. And sometimes you think, oh, this is just a complete disaster, when in fact it's actually a blessing because God is getting your attention. He wants you to teach you something and show you something.
And how many times did he use Paul in the prisons? And he had the guards, the Roman guards, give their lives to Christ.
That's right.
Because he went in and didn't go, oh, miserable me, how did I get myself in this situation? He went in praising God.
Yeah.
And would sit in there and sing.
Yeah, and shackled to a guard.
Yeah.
An example.
And then, you have the perfect audience because he's not going anywhere.
They're not going anywhere.
Captive audience.
Next shift, come on in.
Let
me tell you about Christ.
Yeah.
So,
you know that's
their opportunity.
They had to change him often because he was converting all of them.
Yeah. All the time.
Yeah, it's amazing. You know, my actions caused me, and I'm going to say my actions caused me, but my actions caused a lot of pain within my family and struggle and hurt and not understanding because I ruined two marriages.
Mm.
And from my self-seeking, the drinking and the drugs and you know, three felonies and doing the wrong thing and four rehabs and being in jail and stuff like that. And God was getting my attention. He had a whole purpose, and I never saw it because I was blinded by all of my actions that I wanted to make because it was about me. When you make the worldly decisions, you don't make them with God. Mm. You make them with yourself.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that caused me a lot of struggle, and it caused my family and friends and people that loved me a lot of heartache.
Yeah.
And so, you know, all of us in here have worked that angle, taken it upon ourselves.
Oh yeah.
And I'm going to tell you the key to that is surrender.
That's right.
Right? Mm-hmm. You know, you wave the white flag, and I say it all the time, but it's surrender to win.
Exactly.
And because God can come in and guide your life. And especially today, I mean, I'm getting more phone calls for more counseling, marriage counseling. Men and women are at each other's throats. And,
wow.
And you know, talk about the domination of of fear,
mm-hmm.
and not staying in the action of peace.
Yeah.
And knowing that Jesus knows everything. Listen, we're in end times anyways. We've got lots of things coming.
Yeah.
If we mm-hmm. can if oh, yeah. we can barely yeah. handle just a little bit
yeah.
and we're panicked,
mm-hmm.
what happens when heavier things
yeah.
as Christians, I mean the world is gonna panic.
Yeah, well,
we already know that.
We already know it.
We already have evidence of that. We already know that. But but we as Christians need to take better actions to be the example of I haven't panicked through this whole thing, and that's only because I know Christ is in charge. Mm-hmm. It's not like he forgot what's going on. Oh, I didn't see that. I didn't plan that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yeah. He knows exactly what's going on.
Mm-hmm. He's already overcome all of this.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we need to be, we need to trust God.
Mm-hmm.
And exactly. I mean, there are people who maybe are older and have a few health problems and issues. Mm-hmm. And you know what? All of that is just totally fine.
Yeah.
You know, you have to find your own, and you could watch things on YouTube and everything else. There's so much there within the electronic world to stay connected, and that's very understandable. But coming through this, we have to just know that God's in charge.
Exactly.
No matter what.
Exactly. Right?
And listening to Mike speak about the things that he did that caused pain in his family and around his life, I just want to encourage the listener right now, now watching Mike and seeing the hope he has, the purpose he has, and how he helps other people, you can be there as well. And like he talked about, the step is surrender. Yeah. You don't have to be consumed with shame. Mike's not anymore, right?
No.
Now you live in freedom in Christ because he's forgiven all of those things. And you've been able to reconcile, I would say, what the majority of or all of
absolutely.
Of that pain that you've caused.
Absolutely.
It's created a closeness with these people who once caused pain for.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, and even my father, who had passed away 15 years prior to my getting sober, I got to write him what I call a love letter, you know, to make my amends.
Mm.
And it was just perfect. I trusted God, and I made in writing an amends to my dad and what I put him through, and I was thankful for that.
Yeah.
You know, and we need people to come alongside us and help us through that.
Oh yeah,
you know, it's not like I just had an awakening and I did it all by myself.
Right.
Let me tell you, as I always say, we're better together.
Yeah,
we need each other in this studio, right? If we didn't have Bill, all of us would be. We could talk away, but nobody's going to hear.
Mm-hmm.
We'd be in trouble.
We kind of experienced that this morning.
And we needed Farron, who runs the station today, to try and fix a little glitch, and he found it and took care of it, and then boom, back on the air. So we need each other.
Yeah, God equips the body of Christ.
Amen.
So don't think that you're alone, even if you're home and you're stuck at home and you still have some of that fear.
Yeah,
man, just reach out, ask him, can you come into my life, can you give me some of that peace that these guys are talking about today.
Yes,
you know, to give them some hope.
Yeah.
He'll do that.
He will.
He'll show up right there, right at your house, you know, right in your chair.
Mm. And we can say that with authority because we've all experienced
it. Yes, we have.
Yeah, it's just amazing stuff.
Yeah.
Again, 1-800-721-9313. We'd love to hear about some of your actions and what they did and how you either got through it, or maybe you may be in it right now.
Yeah, right.
You maybe made a decision this morning and it backfired, and now you've got some challenges and struggles. We'd love to pray for you.
Mm-hmm.
We do that anyways through the emails that we get each week. We've heard from many countries. We've heard from people all over the world. And
that's such a trip.
Isn't that amazing? And, you know, we respond to the emails. If you'd love to be a guest, if you have a testimony or story, we'd love to get you hooked up with our producer, Pat.
Which you all do. You've all got testimonies.
That's right.
Yes. Yeah, that would be great. So, you know, you never know. So, anyways... Val, tell us a little bit about maybe some of the your actions and story.
Yeah, so some of my actions, I developed some pretty awful coping skills to deal with some trauma in my life, and that led to eventually losing my nursing license, being convicted of three felonies, and nearly losing my life and my marriage, my kids, everything. I mean, God brought me down to the bare bones. And I, in that moment, realized I needed that prompting to fully surrender and accept him, because I had been a follower of Christ for many, many years. Mm-hmm. I just was so stuck and so worried about revealing and sharing and keeping things hidden in secret, because I was so worried about how everyone would perceive me. Yeah. I didn't think there was really a way to help fix what I had done and help fix the brokenness that was way too deep inside of me, because like Mike always shares about, it's not unique. I was thinking, there's no way someone has done the things that I've done. There's no way that, you know, someone's gone that far. And God revealed, yes, the minute I completely surrendered my life, I mean, fully open, I had to be radically transparent, radically honest about what I had done and also what had been done to me. And in that moment is when I really felt the peace, the joy, everything that everyone had been talking about. Because I have a lot of people in my life that have a close relationship with the Lord. I would hear them talk about this incredible relationship they had and the love that they feel, and that they just seem to be infectious. And I wanted to be there, but I couldn't get there until I was brought to the place I was brought. Some people need a lot of pain in their life to finally surrender.
Yeah, that was me.
I'm one of those.
Yeah, that was me. Yeah, I mean, John, 50 years old, and really living out of my car for 3 weeks and, that hopeless, helpless.
Right.
And I thought that was the best, and I just couldn't really fix myself. But Val, you said something that you, with the uniqueness, thinking that, my friends, what the people are going to think. I mean, that's the thought process that Satan captures you in, right?
Big time.
And he just puts you in that bubble and you can't tell anybody. You're worthless now. Look what you've done. Look what you've done to your family. The humiliation on, and now your career, and people are going to think of you as wretched. You know, I mean, he just tortures you to the fact that he doesn't want you to get any help. What he wants is for you to crawl up and die.
Yeah.
He wants your life.
Yeah,
he doesn't want you to get through this, taking the action and trusting God and saying, Lord, forgive me. Ask for forgiveness, and God forgives you. And there are consequences, which is extra work and things that we have to go through, which is, some of the what we call humiliation, to humble ourselves and say, let me tell you the truth.
That exposure that God allowed brought me more joy, and I learned so much, and I was finally fully willing to follow the Spirit and to fully trust the Lord. I want to tell you about a little story that happened a couple of weeks ago. I went on a worship retreat, and in one of the traumas that I experienced in my life, I was raped by five men. And I was sitting in this room, and we were all going around telling our stories. My husband was there, and then five other men that I work with. And as I was telling my story, and then I got to the point in my story when I was talking about what that rape that happened to me. And as I was looking around the room, looking into the eyes of each gentleman that was sitting in there, God was telling me, you are safe. You are loved. He reconciled. He reminded me that he had reconciled my relationship to men in that moment. Seeing those five men in the room, he exposed, hey, this happened to you with these five men, but look, this is what I'm doing in your life now. I'm going to reconcile and create that bond and that trust and that love.
Wow.
So, amen. Isn't it? That's just amazing. But you've got to trust that process, and you've got to believe in that. Val, that's really powerful.
In
what God can do.
Yes,
because I've been with you through this whole walk, and I've watched you, Polly and I, and I've watched you humble yourself, and take the punishment of having to do things within within a court system. When we get caught doing stuff, we have to jump through some hoops and we can't just avoid it.
Rightly so.
We face it, and you've done that, and I've watched you through that, and I want the listener to get this. It strengthens you.
It
strengthens your belief, and you see who your friends are, and God brings them right next to you, for you, rooting with you, holding you, carrying you, helping you in any way. That's all God. That's orchestrated all by God if we trust the process.
Yes. Right.
I was able to step into the person I was always created to be, which is not a shy person, a pretty hilarious person, I might say myself. John. But if you can relate to that story and you want to call in and talk to us, our number is 1-800-721-9313. We'd love to hear from you.
Yeah, a little shout out to Lou. Yeah. Hey, thank you, Lou. We're praying for you. We know that you're working on your sobriety, and we're in your corner. And we'll continue to love on you, and you just continue to give us some updates because we're praying for you, man.
That's right.
Yeah, amen. Yeah.
And your son, Chevy.
Yeah, oh, there you go.
Great.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It is. Yeah, and I'd like to send a shout out also to Greg, a friend of mine here in town. He's having trouble with his vision. He had to go in for surgery. He's going back in for surgery again this week. Apparently, he's not going to be able to work anymore because they've declared him legally blind in one of his eyes.
Okay.
But I'd like to send a shout out to him and just let him know that we are praying for him and praying for his quick recovery and everything he's going through.
Amen. You know, we do that all week. KNLB that we are broadcasting through prays for people all week. Bill works in the morning and gets lots of prayer requests and praise reports, and he gets to celebrate and ring the bell with people. And he also hears some just heart tugging stories and challenges that people are going through, especially nowadays with the scare and the lack of money coming in, and got two kids and on and on,
trying to go to school.
There's a lot of trying to work and provide, but yet. Still trying to take care of the kids, through schooling and teaching. You know, I watch our pastor's wife, Kim, and she's got four kids, all at different levels, right? You know what I mean? So there's a lot of challenges. I watch her run back from church to go at lunchtime and lunchtime to make sure the morning stuff is done, and did everybody understand the assignments, and then work with them, and then set up the afternoon ones and the projects, and then come back to work, and then go home, cook dinner, and then the after work programs to make sure everybody, did everybody get their schooling done.
You know what's amazing about
it's a challenge.
As you're speaking about that, I'm thinking about Kim, and I'm thinking about the impact she's making by her actions, by checking in on her kids and making sure they're getting things done and providing for them in that way, supporting them emotionally, supporting them with their education. That action is going to create a huge ripple effect for generations to come. Yes. That is God working in your life. She's a godly woman, and she follows Christ. And because of those attributes she has, she's making a huge impact, not only on her children, but her children's children, and so on and so forth.
Amen. Yeah. And we know that there are a lot of other parents out there doing the same thing.
Yeah.
And we just applaud you. We know it's challenging. And we hope that, your husband is as helpful in many other ways, too. You know, it makes a good team, as a husband and wife, when you work together. It makes the burdens lighter, right? It makes life so much better and easier. So, and I know that that's not always the case in many families, especially lately.
Or single parent families.
Or single parents that have to work and everything else. Yeah, yeah.
I want to say happy birthday to Emily.
Emily.
She turned 15 this
she's
week.
She's growing up way too fast. Happy birthday, Emily.
David and Kim's daughter.
And so, Kim has to put up with David, too. Polly has to put up with me.
Don't pick on David. Come on now.
I don't get too many choices. I mean, chances.
He's not in the room.
Yeah, no. So, yeah, he's not here. So, but.
Wow.
Hopefully he's listening. Oh, he'll get you back.
Yeah, he is. No, he will.
He's looking at. They're talking about action. I got an action for him.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Take it easy, John, over Monday, there in the corner.
Monday morning.
Yeah, that's it. Monday morning.
Yeah. Monday morning meetings awkward.
Yeah. Love you. Yeah.
There you go.
Anyway, the listeners, we really do want to hear from you. If you want to give us a call at 1-800-721-9313, or you can email us at recoveryradiolhc.com.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Real important.
Yeah.
You can contact us through that. Right. We'd love to have you as a guest. And, yeah.
Amen. Yeah.
Go from there.
You know, and we've talked a lot about, you know, how actions and turning your life over to Christ and, you know, everything, you have that revelation. Mm-hmm. It's all great. But I just want the listeners to know that, you know, it's not all, I always say this a lot, it's not always rainbows and unicorns when you accept Christ. You know, he's going to put you through trials. He's going to put you through tribulations. Everything you've lived with by yourself, you know, as yourself, because wherever you go, there you are. Those actions you've taken in your life are still going to have repercussions for time to come.
Yes.
But again, going back, you've turned your life over to Christ. You've surrendered to win. You've surrendered to him. Mm-hmm. He is the one that now has the control. Those actions are so, you have peace. Because you know it's all under God. You've turned it all over to him. And it's like, okay, yeah, I messed that up. I made the wrong decision here. And you turn it over to God and you let him take control and he will guide the rest of it. Yeah. No matter where it goes, if it leads to imprisonment, it could lead to imprisonment. Mm-hmm. It could lead to court cases. It could lead to a lot of pain and suffering of family members. But as long as you focus on God and you turn it over to God and you witness to the people that you're around that you've hurt and let them know what happened and seek that reconciliation, mm-hmm. it will all work out in the end to his glory.
That's right.
Not yours. So don't think it's, well, if I do all this, you know, like people get that perception. Well, if I do all this, I'll be a lot better off. It's not about you. Mm. It's all about Jesus, right?
Yes.
All about Jesus, period. It's like, what does it say? Yeah. So that's what you have to focus on.
You know, John, we've been trying to fix the world and fix every situation for thousands of years.
Yeah.
And all we do is we think that we
make
have the answer and that we're able to make it better.
Mm-hmm.
We don't make it any better.
No.
But we think it's worse. Yeah. But one thing that I found now is my actions that I take today are so much better than my actions in my past.
Oh, mm-hmm. I'm so glad you said that.
I make better actions. I say better words.
Yes.
I still struggle with that, saying the better words.
I do better things.
Yeah.
Although we still fall short. Yeah. But
all the time.
I am so much better. I love that you said the word radical change,
mm-hmm.
because that's what took place with Paul.
Yeah.
When Saul was working and Christ stopped him and blinded him.
Mm-hmm.
That's a radical change.
Yeah.
And people, I like hearing that mm-hmm. people will tell me, man, you are a whole nother person than you used to be.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I'm like, thank you. That's only because of Jesus.
That's right.
Right. Nothing I did. All I did was follow some direction. Not my direction for the first time in my life,
mm-hmm.
and trust the process. And when I accepted Christ, really everything changed. And I had that
perception. I had to surrender.
Yeah. You have to.
And until that moment of not surrendering, I mm-hmm. was still kicking and screaming, trying to figure out how to make this work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How to change.
Yes. Although, you know, and he's not going to hog tie you. And, you to the altar.
Yeah,
no.
It goes back to what I said earlier. You accept Christ. You believe everything, right? Mm-hmm. And you accept Christ in your life, but you won't give him the reins.
Yeah.
You still want to drive. Okay, I got that piece. Let me put that in my little tool belt right here. I've got salvation. That's over here in this tool belt. I've got my work life. That's in this part of my tool belt. It's like, that's not how it works.
Mm-hmm.
He wants all or nothing. Don't be lukewarm. I'll spit you out of my mouth.
Yeah.
You know, that's what he wants. He wants your life and he wants all of it. And you need to surrender the whole thing over to him.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. Shout out to Jackie from to Val. Great job. Yeah.
And, there you go.
And Sarah in Yucca Valley just mm-hmm. commented in. You know, thank you. We're praying for you guys. Mm-hmm. Appreciate it.
You know, Mike, you touched on something super, super important I want to bring up really quickly. You talked about the the action comes with a process. It's not an immediate thing. So I want to speak about this because I just had this happen to me this week. I've been really working on my impatience when I'm driving and the words that come to mind. I've started to change the words, and I'm thinking this isn't going to change my reaction in you know, a situation that comes up. So I was at a four-way stop and I went to turn. Apparently I didn't go on my turn. And a guy came up right behind me and got right up on my tailpipe and started flipping me off and cursing me out. And I'm thinking, wow, he must have had a really, really rough morning or something like that, instead of like, what a jerk, you know? So I pulled over very, very calmly, and he passed by me, still cussing at me as he drove by. But I prayed for that gentleman instead of cursing back at him. And that's not anything, about what I did. It's about how God can transform your heart and the way that you do things. Even if you think it's, well, this is silly, this isn't going to change anything. But if you change your thoughts slowly, he'll change your actions.
Amen. Bill, we got a caller on line 5.
Yeah. Oh, great.
Good morning, Sarah. Welcome to Recovery Radio.
Hi, guys. Hi, Val. Hi,
hey.
Bill.
Hey. Hello.
How are you guys doing?
We're doing wonderful.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I just wanted to call in because, like, I was thinking, you know, like, I did make, like, bad decisions in my addictions, and sometimes, like, I'm still paying the consequences of the things, like, that I did. Like, you know, I got felonies, and it stopped me from doing a lot of things that I would like to do, like taking care of children, you know, like, and sometimes you can't do that with felonies on your record, and just a lot of things, you know. But, like, God has been so good to me, and he keeps telling me, I have work for you, you know, and, like, sharing the gospel with people, like, that's something, like, you know, like, no one could stop anybody from doing. You know, like, I keep getting this verse, like, you know, like, don't just fix your mind on temporal things, like, fix your mind on eternal things. You know, like, and that's what, like, God sets a fire in my heart. Like, yeah, there's limitations on my life because of the things I've done, but, like, I've gotten to minister to people and, like, just share Jesus with people, and there's, like, nothing like that in the world. And, like, people are listening that have made mistakes in their life like that, you know, God's got work for you.
And I want to say to you, Sarah, keep trusting that process, because you say, you know, I would love to be able to work with kids. God knows that. He knows the desires of our heart. And we think, just because, listen, I've got 3 felonies, right? Uh-huh. 3 felonies. And I was asked to be a chaplain within the police department. And they do a huge background check. And I just thought, well, there's no way in the world I'm ever going to be able to do that, to be able to give back. And God allowed that to happen. And I'm so thankful because those calls are difficult, you know. They're not good phone calls, and I get to help the officers and help the families or the people within a tragedy. And I'm so thankful that I get to do that. With you, you know, God can make that happen.
Yes,
you know.
Yes,
so he can make anything happen.
Oh yeah.
So so you just keep on trusting him and doing his work in obedience. Yeah. And yes, you're right that sometimes our actions years ago cause us some issues and problems. Now, I know a young lady that had a situation of 2 incidences 40 years ago. And this is very recent, that within the schooling work to help, she had to actually back off of that for a little bit to get those 2 little things straightened out. Sometimes it's just a process, and God will make that happen if you're supposed to do that. So you keep doing what you're doing, Sarah.
Thank you, guys.
Amen. Thanks for
the phone call, man.
Thank you, Sarah. You have a great
day. God bless, Sarah.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, see, that's a, you know, that's a great point. Yes. Our actions sometimes later on, maybe they don't really bite us now, but 10 years later, all of a sudden, we're excited about engaging or doing something, and up there it is.
Sarah really said something that is a treasure. She said about the how it placed the worldly limitations on her life, but there's no eternal limitations. Like we are able, no matter where you are, whether you are in a literal prison or, you know, whatever you've done in your past that you feel like there's worldly limitations, you are never limited in sharing the love of God.
No.
Amen.
No, it's just, and that's where the joy comes.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. You know, and at the same time, well, people say, well, you don't quite understand. And Sarah could say, well, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I too have a little bit of a past, and I got in some trouble.
Yeah,
you know, I hear it all the time.
You, oh yeah, yeah,
because
yeah.
I'm such a goody two shoes now.
Yeah, right.
Sure. So, but I'll get that too, and then I'll tell people of my, you know, my 34 years of addiction and on and on and the chaos that I created, and they just kind of look and go, "Wow, you,
yeah."
Yeah.
And we've all got, we've
everybody's
all got
a past.
You've got everybody out there has a testimony. It doesn't matter what it is,
you
know, and it doesn't have to be something as drastic as, you know, craziness that has happened in some people's lives. I mean, it could be just little stupid decisions you make through your life. You know, not following Christ is number one. That's a dumb decision. But, you know, and you go through your life just making dumb choices from that point on, just about what is going to fulfill me? What do I need to do to I feel better? What do I need to do, you know, that does what I want it to do to make me feel better about myself, you know?
And there, John, and there are actions that other people take. Their actions have caused us.
Oh, yeah.
Many problems,
exactly,
and situations.
Exactly. You know. Yeah, just like as a young boy, and this is a weird one, at a Christian summer camp, I was sexually molested by the counselor.
Mm-hmm.
His action, you know, affected me.
Yes.
You know, and it's like, and he claimed to be a Christian. It's like, where does that come from?
Yeah.
You know, and I had to deal with that a lot of my younger years. And then that whole wanting to be accepted by people because you don't know how to react to people. You don't know how to be in relationship with people.
Right.
It just really distorts your whole perception of everything.
Yeah.
You don't have to having to go through that in my younger years. Mm-hmm. And it's by God's grace alone that I didn't turn to something worse.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, like going into some other kind of addiction, you know, be it, you know, sexual addiction, you know, which I kind of struggle with a little bit, which goes with kind of the codependency type of issue.
Yeah.
Because now you want to find fulfillment in somebody else because you don't know how to do it yourself because of the damage that was caused when you were younger.
Yeah.
You know, but I didn't turn to drugs or alcohol, you know, I didn't go into any of that. So it was just kind of, but I still have those issues in your life and those underlying things that happened and you don't know how to cope. You know, and how do you get into a relationship if it's not physical? What is a non-physical relationship? I totally have no clue. You know, when you're younger and you're trying to, you know, which led into where I ended up with failed marriage after failed marriage because I don't know how to relate.
Yeah.
You know, so it's just, so there's a lot of damage out there. So I don't want people to, you know, think that, you know, it's all about drugs and alcohol. It's, you know, there's other things in your life. You make poor decisions.
Yeah.
And you've got to turn that stuff over to Christ and you've got to find healing. And that's where you need to come together with somebody else. You know, and having a counselor, having somebody, a sponsor, or somebody who can talk to those things and work through those things and you figure it all out.
Yeah.
And you get that joy in your life.
Processing trauma is such an important part. I'll speak for myself. For me, that really was the key to unlock the trust I have in the Lord.
Amen. We got a caller on line three. Good morning, Joanna. How are you?
Good morning, Pastor. How are you?
Very good. Very good.
I just wanted to call in and say this morning that I'm just so grateful that you guys are doing Recovery Radio and just thank you for creating a safe place, just a place where there's no judgment and a place for us to listen and to be encouraged by people's testimonies and just by people's stories. And I just want to say thank you. Thank you so much for what you're doing.
Oh, well, thanks, Joanna. Thank you. Thanks for listening. Thanks for the inspiration.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, that gives us the inspiration when we get to hear from you that you're listening, you're out there. We get a lot of emails during the week, but the personal communication. We just love it. And
thank you so much, Joanne.
Yeah, I mean, really, really important, and we really appreciate it. Obviously, tell us in a minute, Joanna, maybe some of the actions that you took that you had to work through.
Well, as you guys were talking about earlier, we've done things in our addiction that cause, you know, there's going to be consequences, mm-hmm. and we're not going to be free of some of those consequences. We still have to pay restitution or amends or things like that, but you can still do other steps to continue to move forward. You can go to school. Mm-hmm. You can mm-hmm. go and be involved in your community. You can volunteer at Recovery Radio. There's other things that you can do moving forward in your recovery. And I know that I've had to have some doors close on me, which was okay. That was not part of God's plan mm-hmm. for me. Mm-hmm. And I'm okay with that. But there's others that just seem so difficult for me to get through, but God made a way. I've had my conviction set aside. I've got my fingerprint clearance card. I'm able to be a counselor now. I'm able to, you know, go into the jails when I have, you know, mm-hmm. 7 felonies in 2 different states and 3 different counties.
Amen.
Things are possible through Christ mm-hmm. if it is His will.
Yes.
Amen.
Exactly. Amen.
Joanna, thank you so much, man. Thanks for the inspiration.
We love you guys.
Thanks. We love you too. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. Oh, wow.
Well, as you know, thank you, Joanna.
That's a woman walking in freedom right there.
Amen. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
I mean, it's just what an amazing testimony that was right there.
That was.
Hey, we're winding down. I know it's the hour goes by so fast. John, you want to say thank you to our sponsors more time?
Yeah, I'll shout out to the sponsors real quick. Hey, we'd like to thank Ohana Poke Bowl, bringing authentic Hawaiian Poke Bowl and Hawaiian Foods You. They're here in Lake Havasu City at 3269 Maricopa Avenue or on the web at ohanapokelhc.com. Phone number 928-733-5104. Also, I'd like to thank Ace Pest Control, serving the Lake Havasu area for over 20 years with termites, pests, and weed control. You can reach them on the web, acepestcontrolaz.com, or by the phone, 928-680-0988. And, of course, the experienced sales and service at its best with Kyle and the gang down at Sunshine RV in Lake Havasu City at 2995 Maricopa Avenue. Phone 928-855-6648. And with a new Northside location in Havasu on Highway 95 near Dillard's at the Shops. And, of course, Hilltop Community Church providing our shirts and hats and support. 3180 McCulloch Boulevard North at hilltoplhc.com on the web. And, of course, our anonymous sponsor, you know who you are. God knows who you are. We thank you so much for helping.
Yeah. And our T-shirt winner today is Sarah from Yucca.
Yeah, yay. T-shirt or a hat. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Sarah. We appreciate it.
Yeah. Sierra.
It's Sierra?
Sierra?
Oh, we've been calling her Sarah this time.
Sorry, Sierra.
We're a mess.
Well,
her and Michael have been faithful listeners for a long time.
Room for improvement.
Wow, there you go.
Well, hey, you know, I want to thank you guys today. I want to thank our listeners. We hope that we've given you a little bit of inspiration today. I mean, that's what we get to do. We get to give it away. We're inspired by God and His Word and the truth and the love, and He fills us up, and we get to share that.
Right.
And we hope that we've helped you in any way today. We're praying for you, and we truly love you. Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah. For Val.
See, we are a mess.
We are. Bill, as always, thank you.
My name's Valerie.
This lady to my left, the troublemaker. It's easier to call you trouble.
There you go.
Hey, we hope you've enjoyed the show today. My name is Mike. I'm your host. And listen, we're better together. So keep coming back. We'll see you on the radio next week. Have a blessed week.
Goodbye for now from Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you.
I'm not who I used to be. Oh God, I'm not who I used to be. Jesus Christ.
thank God redeemed.